I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. We are now at the boxing laboratory, the home of Vasyl Loamachenko, the home of Sergey Kovalev, and we are talking to one and only Mikey Perez. Mikey, how you feeling?
Feeling good.
So talk to me, how's life been? Let's walk and talk here in the gym. You were here before with Robert and them were here, now you're here with Loamachenko and them, you're sparring him. How's that going?
Going really good. You know, it's always a pleasure to be around fighters that pound for pound fighters, you know, like Mikey Garcia, Vasyl, just all these guys, you know, it's cool being around that kind of atmosphere.
So. What have you learned being around them? Because every time fighters tell me they went around, they learn stuff.
Of course, you know, whoever I'm around, I learn. You know what I'm saying? It don't matter who's in the ring or who I'm around, I'm always trying to pick up something. And that's the name of the game. You're always trying to learn something new.
Have you picked anyone from Loma? Just being around them? You've been here from day one in camp, pretty much.
Yeah, day one. And this is my third camp with them. So, you know, a lot of the mental stuff that he does, preparation, like the mental games and different.
You know how to do
like
all that?
All the numbers on the walls. Yeah.
Show me. Let's go do one really quick. Because I've been trying to ask him about that, and I don't even speak Russian, so it's hard. How did you pick it up?
I asked him, and I asked him how they do it.
And he explained it?
Because it's 25 numbers.
Right. Each square.
Each box, So it's either they go from 25 down to 21. You got to try to find the numbers.
All right, it was explained.
From 1 up to 25.
We'll show people this stuff. Whatever. It's very advanced stuff. And you do it after a three-hour workout.
Times them by two times two. So you go up like that. You go down by two.
And I noticed they time it too, Mikey.
Yeah.
Let's have Mac do it and see who does it faster, you or Mac. You think Mac is a smart dude?
Probably.
Mac, can you do it?
He should be.
We're going to test you right now. So you are looking at the wall of numbers that Vasyl Loamachenko uses every day after he's done training. We have Mac, the coach, Mikey Perez, the boxing star. So let me get in the light here. So Mikey, explain to me, what are some of the drills you guys do here?
They either count down from 25 to 1.
Okay, and how fast do you have to do it?
They just time you to see, you know, improve.
You gotta improve.
Mac, let's time him really quick. How fast do you think you could do it, 25 to 1?
I have no idea.
You've never done it?
Yeah, I've done it. I actually never time myself. I just do it. I go.
So you got all these things, but they're all scattered. They're all different. None of them are the same. So.
Okay, so we're gonna time it here. Sai, 25 to 1.
25 to
1. Hold on, let me start the timer here.
Counting down.
All right, go.
It just said 25 to 1 in like 1 second. That was fast.
Right in front of you. We're at 50 seconds right now. One minute, 5 seconds. Now let's try Mac.
What did
you
do,
25?
All right, but you got to grab another one. You got to do this one.
Okay. Yeah, exactly. You're right. You're gonna... Okay, ready, Mac? All right, go. Mac's a former fighter. He fought Josito Lopez once. Ready. And the time is 37 seconds.
37 seconds?
Not bad, yeah, not bad. So give, show me one more drill, Mikey. So that's one of them.
That's one of them. It's either you count, or you can go from 1 to 25, from 25 but here's to 1. The thing. You go by twos, times them by twos.
They're all different. They're all different. But, and sometimes I see them just staring at them, so I don't know what they're doing because it's got a timer. So I don't know.
Because let's say I have a photographic memory. So if I do this once, I'll know every... You know, like,
yeah, that's why they're all different.
You have, no, but I'm saying if I did them each once, I would know. Because you go to the eye doctor and they tell you the letters. Mm-hmm. I say you have to change it because I already remember from last time.
Oh,
okay,
no.
Give me,
I think I could have done this one faster where Mikey did it once because I already learned.
So give me another one, Mikey.
Some of them you could times by two, like two, four, two. Eight, you know, 10, yeah. 12.
And does it help? Do you feel that it helps?
I mean, it's all about staying focused. They kind of do this, I guess, after sparring or after training and stuff like that. So your mind is staying focused at a longer period of time. You know what I'm saying?
No. You got Mac here. He's been in boxing as a coach, as a fighter many years. You've been in boxing as a trainer and as a boxing star since the amateurs. Have you guys ever seen anything like this ever in any of the stages, any camp? Is this only Loamachenko does this right now?
Yeah, this stuff, a while back when Roberts had some fighters, the manager actually brought in a psychologist.
I remember that.
And it makes sense. I went to a couple of sessions, but it was like a group session. Nothing individual, nothing like this. But
and it wasn't every day. It wasn't after.
Yeah, it wasn't every day. It was just like once every 2 weeks, 3 weeks. You know, a sports psychologist that he helps with the... He was a psychologist for the jockeys. So...
I thought it was for the horses.
I went to a couple of sessions with the sports psychologist, but... he's with them every day, so they got drills every day. You know, not just this one; they got a bunch of other different drills, like about an hour worth of psychological drills. Yeah,
when he was here, I asked him a question he couldn't answer. I said, "Why do some guys look so amazing in the gym, but in the fight they don't do the same? I mean, it's the same thing, same motions." Thank you. But Mike, if you show me one more. So you said that, say that one we got 25-1. Like, what's, pick another square.
Pick a square.
Hollywood squares. Okay, what are you supposed to do here?
See, this one is, you would think this one is like, how can I say? You see how this one is? It's not all black. All the numbers are black.
Yeah.
So some are red, some are black. So it kind of tricks your mind.
Right.
You see, you, let's say you pick a number from 10, and then you're looking for black. You're looking for black, but actually the 11 would be red or something like that. So it kind of tricks
your mind. It throws you off, yeah.
It's like these. Each box different color. The numbers are different colors. So it kind of tricks your mind. So it makes it.
Mind plays tricks on you. Yeah, so what do you have to do in this one? Same thing?
Or same thing. Things? I mean, they pick and choose. Like I said, they do different stuff. They could times them by twos, by fours, and do it like that, or do from 1 to 25 down to one. I mean, they just mix it up. They do different things.
Do you feel that it helps?
I think so. You know, it keeps you focused. It keeps you keeps your mind sharp. You know, I believe that your mind is the most important thing out of everything.
Of course, especially you've been in war sometimes where you're tired. You're not listening to the court. This is where this will kick in.
Mental fatigue.
Yep.
I think it builds your mind. You know what I'm saying? Because.
When you first saw him do this, did you understand it? Do you like, what is this for? Or are you like, wait, I just worked out for 3 hours. I'm dead tired. I just want to go home.
No, I actually didn't know what he was doing. I kind of look and I kind of try to determine what he was doing. I know he was
we saw
picking
that.
Numbers
yep.
and stuff. But I asked him and I told him, what does he do? And he says he counts down from 1 to 20. I mean, he counts up from 1 to 25, down from 25 to 1. He times them by 2. You know what I'm saying?
Makes 2, 4, dish, 6, 8.
Yeah, times them by 6. You know what I'm saying? It makes it harder. Makes
Harder. That's like, because I said, if you already know the order of the numbers, it's hard.
So they switch it up. You know what I'm saying? They always switch it up. And then, like I told you, some boxes are different different colors.
Some are red, some are black.
So him personally, yesterday, he said, this one is the hardest, one of the hardest. He said, and this one right, I think. Because the color changes and all that stuff, I guess. All
right. So there you have it. Tell people where to follow you.
Michael.Angelo.Perez. That's my Instagram.
Shout out to Grateful. Instagram. Always look out for you.
Yeah. Grateful. They always got to be grateful.
And you've been in camp. You've been grateful of being camp with Loamachenko from day one. And how's the sparring going? Because he's incredible. Very impressive. It's like watching
TV. He's in great shape. I learned, man. I'm in there, just his feet movement, the way he moves, the way he picks shots and does his things. I mean, every day he's working on something new, you know what I'm saying? And that's what that's what sparring is about. People think sparring is...
a war.
It's just you go in there and try to beat each other up, and you don't get nothing out of sparring like that, you know what I'm saying? I'm here, I'm helping him out, and at the same time, he's helping me out, you know? I'm learning.
Every day.
Every
Your
day.
Prediction, Lennar Somachenko, great fight?
It's gonna be a good fight. But I'm leaning towards Lennar. It's just Loamachenko, because just skill wise, man, just he's something special.
What did you make of the Adrian Broner or Jesse Vargas fight?
Close fight. I think Broner came on a little too late in the fight. I don't know what he was waiting on, but he came on a little too late and he started pushing the action later on in the fight. It was a draw. You know, I think it deserved a draw. Who knows? I gotta sit there and freaking.
You weren't scoring it round by round, but how about this?
It was close though.
How about Charlo Centeno?
Charlo brothers.
Did you know them ever before?
Man, yeah.
Well, how long ago?
I lived in Texas actually for 3 years.
Really? Why?
And I fought. My father. Unfortunately, he got locked up. He went to jail, and my mom needed help with money and stuff like that. So my uncle lived in San Antonio.
Your dad's a cool dude, man. Yeah. I can't see him being like the head guy in jail. He was a shot caller.
So we moved down there. I lived down there for about 3-4 years, and I trained in Tony Ayala's boxing gym in San Antonio. I was actually number one in the state for all those years.
It's a big boxing state.
Yeah, big boxing state. And just to get out of that state, it takes a lot. I fought. I don't know if it was Jermell or Jamal.
You're kidding.
One of them two, anyways.
You're like a 135 pounder.
So we fought at 32 at that time. I was like about 14, 15.
Did they
years
have
old.
Crazy power at 32?
They carried. I think they carried their power at that age. So it's just.
They're very quiet.
Yeah, very quiet.
But they're deadly. Quiet, no, but deadly.
Man, they good people. And
yeah, good energy. I like because they talk shit.
I'm a big fan from both. You know,
Jermaine and like Jamal. Them. Can you like tell them. Who's who? I can.
Yeah, yeah. They actually look different. You know what I'm saying?
Some
yeah,
people
you
can.
Tell. Yeah, you could tell. You could tell. You could tell the difference. But
so you're proud of them and what they're doing?
Yeah, most definitely.
Okay.
Man.
Do you want to see Jamal Triple G?
Yeah, why not?
What do you think?
I'm pulling for Jamal, man. I think them guys just they're real basic in boxing, but they're freaking
freaks power.
They're strong. I mean, they don't do nothing flashy in the ring. None of that. It's strictly just fundamentals. You know what I'm saying? And that go to show you that you don't have to be all flashy, you know, all that extra stuff. And Mikey's another guy that fights like that too. You know what I'm saying?
Mikey Garcia.
Yeah, Mikey Garcia. He knows how to pick his shots, and he throws one-twos hooks, nothing out this world, you know what I'm saying? But he does it.
He's basic,
well,
but very effective.
Very effective in what he does, you know? And
you spar him, you spend a lot of time around him.
Yep.
But he's like them. He's also, Mikey's a very good dude.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. All right, message to your fans if they're watching?
Message my fans, you know, stay tuned. I'm working on my next fight, hopefully soon. I've been out for about a year.
But being in camp with Loma is like, yeah, getting ready for a war. You're in shape.
Hopefully some of these guys, man, accept to fight me. You know, I just feel that I'm too much of a risk for a lot of these guys. And, you know, and politics go into play too, you know what I'm saying, when it comes to boxing. Just stay tuned, and I'll be back, man. I'm going to make some noise.
One more time, where do they follow you?
Follow me at michael.andrew.perez. That's my Instagram.
Stay tuned. Thank you so much for the explanation and the interview. For ESNEWS.com, I'm Zekbach reporting. About 15 minutes ago, this place had maybe 100 people in it, and now look at it. Exactly. It's all yours, Mikey. You can go work out, hit the bag, work out in two different rings.
I'm gonna work out now. I think what's the MMA guy? UFC?
TJ Dillashaw.
Yeah. He said he wanted to do a few rounds. So.
Right now with you?
I think so. I think he wanted to do
a few rounds. He has a big fight? Where's he at?
I don't know. But we'll see.
Okay, if Mac made a comeback, who should he fight?
Cuate.
Okay, Cuate, do you box? Do you box?
In the street, yeah.
No, in the ring, not on the street. You and Mac in a real fight. In a, like boxing, not real fight, like boxing match.
Say, tell him you break him.
He doesn't box.
Nah, Mac. Marcos he's an
ex-fighter. He's also a good trainer.
He likes Seckbach.
Cuate, can you take a picture of me, Mac, and Cuate? And,
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.